How was yesterday's exercise? Did y'all catch the how I call that? Do the discerning? Yeah, wholesome, unwholesome. What exercise? As I've said many times, most of these exercises is actually meant to be done over a long time. Yeah. Some years back when I was in the I often highlight this example, but over time it becomes you start to see it here and there. The example I give is the one in Myanmar. Yeah, but there was once in when I was in the US. Again, it's my own choice. So our unwholesome thoughts don't wait for a special time to come. Yeah. They don't look at the feng shui, they don't look at the timing and say, okay, today is a day to come. Or what is the timing? They come whenever they want to come. Yeah. So one day I was going, when I was in the US, our dormitory is on the upper end of the mountain. So the hall itself was built on the bottom of the valley. Yeah. And it's a open space. So we would climb, we would go down the stairs to the main hall for our practices. So there was one day, I think I was going down for class. Yeah. So open the door, close the door, walking down. Then I took a few steps. Then suddenly I caught myself. I was having some not so happy talks towards one of the senior monks. Some of you, when you first time hear this, you'll be like, huh? Sifu ordained already. Then in the monastery, I thought he was there, wow, doing powerful practices. Then having not so happy thoughts towards senior monk. Okay, so first things first, the moment I caught myself, I was like, wow. How can this be happening? Or rather, like, you know, oh, so quickly dispel it. And someone going to class, someone. Jiala, I tell you. So I tell you, of course, now many people sort of don't go to the temple because of the pandemic. Even though it has opened up, sometimes the whole process of making an appointment and then going down, you know. But don't be surprised when you go to do Dhamma work or you do go to do Dhamma practices, then sometimes you find the unwholesome thoughts arise, you know. Yeah. So then the question is, how can it be? Yeah. Monks, you know, staying in the monastery, in the mountain, you know, wow. When people go to our place, from Taiwan, they come and visit my teacher, and then they stay for maybe usually stay for a week or so. And then they'll, you know, in the morning, after breakfast, then sometimes they'll talk to us, and then they'll praise the place and say, wow, 法师啊, 这个地方太幽静了。 这个地方特别的清静，磁场特别好。 Yeah, you'll say like, Venerable, this place is so nice and quiet, so pure. The energy is so good. Yeah. And then, sometimes they'll even say like, oh, how I wish I can stay here. And then we'll tell them like, then stay lah. Why do you stay here? Then, oh, no. No, I cannot stay here. most people think that the monks and nuns, when we go to the mountain, stay in the mountain and then practice there, then shouldn't have any, we should have all super pure thoughts. But then how come Sifu say that, you know, he even have unhappy thoughts towards the senior monk? Yeah, I remember one senior told me this when I was there for maybe just a few months. So one day, I really appreciate all the senior monks because they were in their own way checking on me and ask me like how things are. So this particular senior, 智玄法师, I usually talk about 智道法师, right? So this other senior monk, 智玄法师, he has passed away, colon cancer. So at that point in time, one day he came to talk to me, and then he asked me like how I am and things like that. Then after all the pleasantries has been done, then he asked me like, do you find that it's very strange that you quit your job, you ordain, you come here, and then you find that how come among the monks there seems to be it's not a very friendly, super, you know, like cordial. Then I'm like, how come people don't appear to be that kind of like very I said, and then he said, and as compared to the corporate world, people are nicer, isn't it? then I thought about it, true. then he told me, he said, do you know why? Then I think about it, I said, why? Then he said, because in the corporate world, there are vested interests. In the corporate world, nobody want to, sometimes he will switch between English and then sometimes Mandarin, and he's from Hong Kong. So sometimes he's from Canada. And I think previously from Hong Kong. So he will sometimes switch into Cantonese also. So he will say like, because they are, even if you are not happy with someone in the corporate world, you don't want to burn bridges. You don't dare to, offend anyone, and nobody want to offend you also, not in your face anyway. Yeah. So they put on a mask. They be nice and gentle to you. Yeah. But behind you, then, that's true also. Right? In the corporate world, everybody like very super nice to each other. Wow, good job. Then behind, later the review, still like that. how is the thing going to sell off? No problem, man, count on me, no problem. Then in the end, the deal went to somebody else. And then the person said, I tried my best, man. Then in the end, you heard from somebody else. He's the one who highlighted all the problem. Then he's the one who suggested to go with the other vendor. What happened? Things like that. Then he said, and why is it that in the monastery, people are quite like blunt with each other? He said, because the monastery is a safe place. Yeah. A safe place where you don't need to put on a mask. Yeah, you can be direct with each other. Yeah, and furthermore, he said, all of us come from different background. When you're in a corporate world, more or less, you're more or less the same circle. Then you work together, ma. Yeah, but in the monastery, all of us from different countries, different backgrounds, different age. Different number of years of learning, everything different. And furthermore, all with defilements, stuck in a place, cannot do anything else. Confirm, have conflict. And I thought of it, oh, that's very true. Mm. Yeah. So, So over the years, this is another thing which I often think about. Yeah. And perhaps that's why later on when I go to other centers, other monasteries and stay, or I meet different devotees and so on, and there's conflict, maybe I'm numb to it. But I like to think that I see it slightly differently. Yeah. We're not enlightened, other people also not enlightened, ma. Right. How can we? Of course, there'll be conflict. That's why I always tell the volunteers, you can question each other's methods, but don't go and question each other's intention. Yeah. Because when you question each other's intention, then no need to talk already. Anything the person say or do, no matter how the person try, you have doubts. Yeah. But this can only happen. This is possible to see. It's more possible. I don't say this is the only way, but it's more possible to see this way when you see the unenlightened state in yourself clearly. Yeah. When you see how from day to day, unenlightened states arise. Before we learn Dhamma, we don't feel like we have a lot of unwholesome thoughts or no. Right? Yeah. Before we learn Dhamma, we feel like we are quite good. Huh? And then the Lao Hok can always say, Sim Guan Ho Lu Ho. Yeah. That the heart good, that's enough. But what we don't realize usually is even the very definition that the heart is good don't qualify if you compare with what the Buddha taught. Yeah. Not suggesting you are all evil people. No. But it's that when you see the fault in the smallest thing, yeah, in ourselves, then slowly we'll progress. Slowly we'll progress. The sixth perfection, we are now on the fourth, on diligence effort. Mm. Diligence to perfect the other parami starts off with identifying and seeing the qualities, whether we are in a wholesome state or whether we are in an unwholesome state, to see that clearly. Yeah. It's quite a painful process. But if you bear with it, before that, patience, right? If you bear with it, don't go and bear with it in the wrong way. Don't bear with the unwholesome states. In a sense that don't condone the unwholesome states, okay? But bear with this painful process from the discomfort of looking at yourself, including when people, if you are lucky, if you are fortunate, if you have the good merit, that people point out your unwholesomeness, to have patience with it, you have the fortune of someone highlighting to you, but cannot wait for people to highlight, have to check ourselves. Then slowly, then when you see it very clearly, initially we see it, but we may still succumb to it, so what's the problem? No problem, that's part of the process. But when you see it and you see the problem with it, seeing it and seeing the problem with it is two different things. It's like smokers, you think they don't know that they are smoking, they know they are smoking. You think that they don't know that smoking is not the best thing for them, they know, but they don't fully appreciate it. But when they fully appreciate it, that the danger in it compared to the benefits, there's benefit in smoking also, no? Do you know? There's benefits. You think smokers are stupid? They're not stupid. Similarly, we see benefits in our defilements, you know. Yeah, we like our defilements. If we don't like, we are not so stupid. We don't like why we keep doing it. Because we like our defilements. We like to be greedy. We like to be angry. We like to be deluded. You know, we like. Yeah. So I have to see it clearly. See clearly that this has faults and danger. Oh, yeah. And as I said, while we alternate between the practices on a day-to-day basis, sometimes at most 2 days, but many of these practices is meant to be done over several months, several years. And if I should say so, not to frighten you, it's actually meant to be done for your whole life. Yeah, until it's totally purified. Oh. So continue with this, the right effort practice. And for those who yesterday, when you try to discriminate or try to discern and discriminate between the wholesome and unwholesome state, beneficial and harmful states, if it's not very clear, then just continue. For those who are somewhat clear, then see whether you can use different techniques to overcome the unwholesome states, yeah, and the wholesome states to help it grow. If the unwholesome states are not present, don't think that it's just watching for unwholesome states. Also watch for absence of unwholesome states. And if unwholesome states are not present, then work towards the non-arising of the unwholesome states. If wholesome states are not present, work towards its arising. Now, there are four, there are two pairs, four sets. Okay? Have a diligent day ahead. Amitabha.